आंख है अभी भी थोड़ा बाहर है हाँ, और इस वक्त इसको हम आगे लाएंगे और उसके वजह से आंख भी अंदर ठीक से बैठ जाएगा.
Shaylee will have surgery to bring forward the middle of her face, creating a more rounded shape, and eye socket reconstruction so her eyes will sit deeper into her skull. The operation carries risks of excessive bleeding and infection.
The surgery to be performed is a complex surgery. It involves bringing the entire middle part of her face, which includes three bones, the nasal bones, the upper jaw bone in toto as a single piece, forward by at least a centimeter. And this would allow the eyeball to go in so that her protruding eyeball will no longer be at risk and she will be able to close her eyes normally.
The operation will go ahead in the morning and Shaylee struggles to hold back her tears.
अंदर से तो मैं बहुत डरा हुआ और शैली को देख के तो थोड़ा हिम्मत तो करना होगा.
It's the big day of the operation, and doctors begin by shaving Shaylee's scalp.
अभी नींद ना जाएगा, सो जाओ, ठीक है? सो जाओ.
Shaylee is stable, and the operation has been a success.
I think that will take care of Shaylee's current problems. Everything else we'll get to see only after the swelling subsides.
All right, 1, 2, 3.
After an anxious wait, Shaylee's father is desperate to see her.
Shaylee, तो जब बाहर आई तो अभी थोड़ा होश में तो नहीं है.
Shaylee now needs to recover and wait for the swelling to go down to see the full results. Two weeks later, and Shaylee is making a remarkable recovery.
मेरे उंगली देखो, इस तरफ, अभी इस तरफ ऊपर, नीचे.
Shaylee's face is now rounder, and her eyes are protruding less.
We are quite pleased with the outcome at the moment, and her eyeballs are in the right position. She is able to move her eyes normally.
Normally, सीधा face हो गया और बिल्कुल वो नाक भी खड़े हो गए उसको. पहले से बेहतर लग रही है और जब उसके बाल आ जाएंगे तो वो बिल्कुल अच्छी लगेगी.
As her bones grow in the future, Shaylee may need further treatment.
अब मुझे ये सब की कोई चिंताएं नहीं रहेगी कि शैली मेरी ऐसी दिखती है. अब वो इतनी क्यूट हो गई है कि अब उसे कहीं भी ले जा सकते हैं, कहीं भी खेलने के लिए. अब वो कहीं भी जाके खेल सकती है हम बच्चों की तरह.
After 27 previous operations, Dylan is having his biggest surgery yet. The team will cut out the mole-affected skin on his back and replace it with clear skin created by expanders inserted into his chest.
You don't want to be done. He doesn't want to leave this.
Despite their anxiety, brothers Patrick and Dominic are putting on a brave face.
It's hard on them to see everything that he's going through and to know that they can't do anything more to help him than they can.
Doctors prepare to put Dylan under a general anesthetic.
Give your brother hugs and kisses.
The hardest part of this is probably saying goodbye to him at the doors and not being with him when he's been put to sleep.
Teach her how to play.
I bet you're better at math than she is.
I bet you are. I don't think I have left fingers and toes for this.
The first stage of Dylan's surgery is for surgeons to remove the two saline-filled balloons in his chest. After establishing how much new skin is available, they mark out an area that will be replaced and cut it out. With Dylan being closely monitored, they stretch his new skin over the area where the moles have been removed.
The goal is to take out as much of the nevus as possible and to bring this expanded skin into that area and then close.
With nothing.
Cara and Nikki wait on any news.
All right, when are you guys going to do it? I'll see you
We had one surgery where, you know, things didn't go quite as planned, and so it was pretty scary. You can't dismiss the worries and the fears. You've got to have those.
Eventually, they're given an update.
The doctor came in and explained to us that he has done with surgery now.
The surgeons have been able to remove a mole-covered area measuring 180 squared centimeters. And once healed, Dylan will be back to full mobility.
He said his baseball arm was going to be fine.
I guess
that's always good to hear from me.
Let me hold it so you can get wrapped up.
The next morning, Cara gets to take a closer look at a tired and emotional Dylan.
On this one, it used to go over to right here, so they were able to advance all that skin over here.
That way.
And I mean, as you can see, his nipple's displaced right now because they keep moving it over. And then on this side, he actually doesn't have one anymore because they've already removed it and removed so much skin. And it's way over here.
All right, now it's time to wrap you up.
The plan is now to go home and get him relaxed and feeling better.
The pain endured is a small price to pay for saving Dylan's life in the long term. It's the day of their appointment in Lima, and Jobden and Yuki are anxious for answers.
Me gustaría que me revise todo, el doctor, que me dé un buen resultado.
Dr. Emilio Cabello has studied growth disorders for over 30 years. Dr. Cabello carries out a range of medical tests, from physical examinations to bone x-rays.
Tenemos 84 centímetros. Tienes un centímetro más que tu hermano. Muy bien, muy bien. Te felicito. A ver, déjame escucharte un ratito el corazón. Muy bien, está muy bien este corazoncito. Esta es la radiografía de Jobden, que más o menos tiene un estimado de 7 años de edad ósea. Comparado a los huesitos de acá, probablemente estamos alrededor de los 6 años y medio.
Further genetic testing is required, but initial results all point to one diagnosis. For Jobden and Yuki, it's the moment of truth.
El resultado de todo ello nos lleva a la conclusión de que probablemente ustedes tienen un síndrome que se denomina el síndrome de Laron. El síndrome de Laron es una situación clínica en la cual los niños tienen un crecimiento muy bajo. La edad ósea se retrasa y el desarrollo sexual también se retrasa.
Laron syndrome is caused by the liver being unable to process a growth hormone, known as IGF-1. There are only 350 known cases in the world, over 100 of which are in South America. It is thought to have originated from one Sephardic Jewish refugee from Spain or Portugal in the 15th century, who was a carrier of the mutant gene.
Pero de qué cosa agarra esto, doctor? Porque es una enfermedad o qué?
No es un problema que por una maldición ni nada por el estilo, sino es un problema genético que ha sido transmitido por los padres.
Y doctor, ¿nosotros normal podemos crecer como mis amigos?
Con el tratamiento podrían beneficiarse unos centímetros más. Sin embargo, el tratamiento no es un tratamiento sencillo, es un tratamiento de varios años.
With hormone injections, they could gain 10 to 15 centimeters in height.
De que podamos disponer de esta hormona. Esta hormona no existe en este momento disponible en el Perú. Habría que ver la posibilidad que alguien nos pueda proveer de otros países. Muy bien, Yuki y Jobden, ha sido un gusto verlos realmente. Estaremos viéndonos en otra oportunidad.
Gracias.
Un gusto saludarlos.
Gracias.
Chao.